What's going on, Power Squad? Willpower here, rocking the Willpower Merc with
Hola, Escuadrón de Fador, soy Ethan.
Eso mismo, dímelo cantando, a city. So, we met up with one of my clients, Sid, for the next rehab we're taking care of for her. Sunday, I pulled an all-nighter editing freaking today's video.
Gee, bro, how much sleep did you get last night?
Well, last night I took some ZQL to force myself to sleep. Nice. I got like 5 hours.
Nice, bro, that's like a record.
And yeah, it's a Scarface tribute. I hope you guys like it. I really enjoyed creating it and putting it together. Very funny little clips. Right now we're driving for dollars in the Marietta area, doing what we do best. Helicopter is down, waiting on some parts for maintenance. And then we'll be doing some more flying for dollars, because that's how we grow at Willpower.
Yeah, buddy. Shoot, man. We're over here in Cobb County. LaFever, where you at?
We're driving for dollars for you, rock and roll. We got you, we got you.
Rock and roll, Sid.
Rock and roll,
work for y'all, man.
That's right. It paid off to deal with Willpower. We're all gonna make money together.
Yo, 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 yo! Rocking the merch, bruh. That's what I'm talking about, dude. Man's got his own font.
His own merch.
We don't say merch, we say merch.
That's right.
Your merch don't stink, merch, right?
Nope. These are some nice houses to convert to a little modern.
They was doing a modern house back there.
Rocking the bucket hat.
Throwing shots, bro.
I'm the best ever. I'm the most brutal and vicious and most ruthless champion there's ever been. There's no one can stop me. Lynx is a conqueror. No, I'm Alexander. He's no Alexander. I'm the best ever. There's never been anybody ruthless. I'm Sonny Liston. I'm Jack Dempsey. There's no one like me. I'm from Nairclaw. There's no one that can match me. My style is impetuous. My defense is impregnable. And I'm just ferocious. I want your heart. I want to eat his children. Praise be to Allah.
That content creator boxing.
This guy's talking about my intelligence.
This beef definitely seems real.
That's what they're doing now.
Sign the contract, big boy. Sign the contract.
So the YouTube influencers are boxing. You think you could beat a Viet?
I can beat anything. The question is, does the vet think you can beat me?
Well, it's a fight. So whatever happens, happens.
Mike, why do you have to talk like that?
Well, I'm talking to you the way I want to talk to you. You have a problem, turn off your station.
You know what? I think we'll end the discussion right now.
Then we could.
You got it. Have a nice fight, Mike.
Fuck off.
There, look. Bam.
Got that thing.
Got one. Bless you, my son. Bless you. God bless you, my son. Bless you. Bullshit. Left on 2-1 and Lewis, some brothers shooting dice, so I said, let's do this. The next stop is the East Side Motel. Let's go to East Side. Right. East Point. Left. A la izquierda. Izquierda.
A la izquierda. Like they're doing some work to it, maybe? Mm-hmm.
El Cuban es mi favorito.
And it's our first flip.
What's going on, Power Squad? Will Power here, and I'm with
Ethan Crow.
You already know.
Oh, that one back there?
What, back there? Those ones?
Yeah, let's get it right.
Oh, look at this one.
What do you think?
Two of them. Nice.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
No.
We got these two here.
Maybe down there? I don't know.
Another one right there. Boom. Got another one. And another one. And another one. Another one. Look at that, huh? How do these people live, dog? Welcome to the jungle. What's going on, Power Squad? And we're at a dead end. You know what they say at the end of a dead end? We find a gem right there, buddy. Don't be lazy. Don't be lazy. When you see that dead end, pull up. Thank me later. Right?
Yeah, buddy.
What do I keep on saying about dead ends? What do I keep on saying about dead ends? There's always, always gems at the end of a dead end. As you can see, dead end. Yeah, buddy. Across this little gem right here, burned down. Boom. Oh, and another one. We got another one. Yo, right here, driving by, this house doesn't look distressed, but there's a lockbox. Willpower pro tip.
And I'm doing something real special today. Got a gentleman that I had never met personally. But I had seen him online and he did a little video. No, let me correct that. Because it was a short video, but I don't want to minimize and say it was a little video because it meant a lot to me when I saw it. And but this is Mr. Will Power Turnkey. And he's going to explain that to you. I got a tattoo right there. It's really cool. It's really cool. You see it right there. And he is a real estate investor. And he kind of new to this world of the wholesale world. So... Will, welcome to Miss Tycoon Uncut. Welcome again. You know, we took a little time before we came on and talked and got to know each other. And so, Will, give us a little brief history. You know, we're going to run about 10 minutes on this one. But give us a little brief history of yourself, your history, and, you know, why you made the video and how you got here.
Originally from Miami, I'm Cuban, ended up here in 2010, got into renovations, been doing it for over a decade, dealing with investors that flip houses. I never started Willpower to be a big contracting firm or company. I started to get the knowledge because I knew I wanted to get into flipping myself and be an investor, so I started the renovation company to get the knowledge. So I paid attention to where investors were buying, what color scheme, their crews, this and that. And then came wholesaling, it's kind of the same thing.
I don't have it to you, Mr. Sosa. You got everything a man could want.
I want to give a shout out to Mr. Tycoon for inviting us out yesterday to drop some knowledge into tomorrow's future.
I like you, Tony. There is no lying in you.
We always talk about financial literacy, right? This William was there with us at one point in time. She talked to y'all about the rat race. Then we talked about business plans, and we talked about taxes as well. So guys, this is about real estate. Everybody needs a house. Everybody needs some type of shelter, right? So a lot of people get into real estate because you want to provide that service for them, right? Because when you have a business, you want to provide speakers because somebody needs speakers, right? Somebody needs a place to live. So right here we have Mr.
Tycoon.
This is Tycoon. This is one of his properties right here in Atlanta.
Put it here.
Say literally nobody. Because do I have to go to college?
No, you don't have to go to college to do this business. So that, but you do have to know math. So you got to bear the count.
Who can tell me what the cash flow is if I'm paying 11 and I'm paying 2200 and I'm getting 2200? Yes, sir.
1100.
1100. Well, I got something for you. I only brought one. It's called Success is Not a Secret, it's a System. Thank Miss Rhea Nikki because she gonna buy this book from me so that I can give it to you. So she didn't know that, but now she does, and I'm gonna sign it for you before you leave. So that's for you. And I only brought one, but I only had one. So first of all, let's thank Miss Rhea Nikki because she's the one gave me this opportunity. And I want to thank you all for coming and being a part of this program. But I want to say this to you: take your education seriously. But also, I want you to start thinking about what it is that you want to be right now so you can start putting in that time. Mm-hmm. Just like the time you put into those games, you can start putting that time into whatever career you want to do. And you're never too young to start thinking about real estate. How many of y'all play Monopoly? Okay. So you understand in the game Monopoly, if you don't own no property, it's a sad day, ain't it? You'd rather go to jail than keep going around paying rent. And we ain't trying to go to jail, right? No. But the thing is, Monopoly, it's no fun if you don't own no property. Yeah, Mediterranean, another one. They cheap properties, you don't get a lot of money for them, but it add up over time. But everybody usually want to go for Boardwalk. And what's the other one with Boardwalk?
Park Place.
Who said that? Because Monopoly, that's the professor back there. I mean, you should know. But again,
we ain't on this level, apparently.
You leave them here. We're going to put them in the bucket. Will, hell no. We gangsters.
Lost in the foundation.
What I need from y'all, if y'all do one thing for me, I'd like to get a video and put y'all on IG with me if y'all don't mind. Is it okay, teacher?
Yeah,
here we go, here we go. You ready? What's going on, superstars? You know who it is. Yours truly, Mr. Tycoon, the undisputed king of wholesaling and your personal guru. And I'm here with Miss Rhea Nikki. She got a group here. We're talking about financial literacy. And today we're talking about real estate investing. Because everybody got to have a place to what? Say live.
Live!
And we like to make, say, a lot of money. Talking about how I got started with wholesale with no money and no cash, but now I work my way up. I started at the bottom, now I'm what?
At the top!
Okay! And Mr. Tycoon is what? Alright, remember, in order to get your money right, you gotta get your mind right. And we out. Say peace!
Peace!
Oh, y'all are amazing.
Y'all explore, and then we're going to talk about it at Atlanta, Kentucky over some snacks. So I need y'all to have some good questions in there, and we'll talk about it at Atlanta, Kentucky. Y'all got it? All right, so go ahead.
Take a minute when we go right here.
Where do you got? Let me know it now.
Okay. How y'all doing? Yeah. Okay, I need the playground voices. I'm from Decatur, where is what?
Okay,
you said that?
Know.
Okay. We got some real ones in the building. But first of all, thank you all for coming out. Hope that I can say something that helps you all in life. Because first of all, how many of y'all like money? Let me hear you say you like money. Say, I like money.
I like money.
Okay, now one thing for certain is everybody got to have a place to live, right? Now, some people pay rent and some people own the property, right?
Yes.
Okay, so she said, let's talk about some of the numbers real quick. I paid $60,000 for the house. Okay, that house right across the street that you see right there, that house just sold for $220,000. And it's in terrible shape. We've already fixed this one up, the house in the area. This house is gonna be worth about $300,000. Now y'all say, it's probably still like it's in the hood, right?
Yep.
But how close are we to downtown? Okay, so you hear about regentrification. What that means is, come in, look closer. I wanna get mad. That's when the white folks start coming to the area. And the area start getting better. But that's the truth. But the thing is, we can turn our areas around if we start taking care of our properties, right? Okay?
So let's do the math on this. I paid 60 for it. I put 30,000 into it over the last 2 years. So 30 and 60 is what?
90.
Okay. Subtract 90 from 300 is what? 210 what?
Thousand.
Say that again.
Thousand.
$210,000 in equity. Now, what do I mean by equity? It's not cash because it's just sitting in the house. Because if I was to sell the house and I go get a realtor, I got to pay them 6%, and then I might not get the full $300,000. But what this asset is for my son when he's ready to go to college, who's 14. So if he want to go to college in 4 more years and he got $200,000, y'all think that's enough for him to go to college without having to have student loans and all that kind of stuff?
Yeah.
Right. So that's why we want to start looking at real estate even while we're your age. So you want to keep your credit together. Your what?
Credit.
Credit. And you want to start keeping your money together so that you can buy stuff and then turn around and resell it. And that's how I got started in this business. The first way I got started in this business called me selling. We good? We good over there? Mr. Grace Car Drive, ain't nothing coming down the street.
Nope.
So it's called wholesaling, where I used to just find the houses and then take them to investors who had the money to buy them, and I got what's called the spread or the middle money. I was the person who just go find the deals. But now I've come to the position in my real estate investing career where I can actually buy them and keep them and hold them and turn them into rentals. So it's just like going through the grading system. We're gonna go inside. I don't know if they left the air on. We got some paint on the wall, so watch your clothes. I don't want you to get no paint on you. And even how that's how me and Miss Renikia know one another is from the real estate business world. And she called me last minute. Those two gentlemen behind you right now, they real big time investors.
Hello.
And this one right here, back to y'all, to my right, y'all left behind. She's a new investor because she want to learn this business. So she's in real estate investor school, just like y'all in school. And so the thing is, I want y'all to understand, you ain't gotta have to be a rocket scientist to do this. But you already got one of the number one skills you need, and that's math. Because math is what making money is all about, understanding the percentage and things of that nature. So let's walk it, ask any questions you like. And one of the reasons that I like real estate, because we can make a whole lot of what?
Money!
Money. All right. Come on, Superstar, y'all shoot
him, Mr. Tyco. We ready. What's going on, Power Squad? The Power here, 1 hour in the sauna.
No fresher than hoe, riddle me that. The rest of y'all know where I'm lyrically at. Can't none of y'all mirror me back.
You know, all eyes on me.
Buffalo G.
This country, you gotta make the money first. Then when you get the money, you get the power. Then when you get the power, then you get the woman. That's why you gotta make your own moves.
Willpower.
Don't hire help, build the team, build the dream.
Reach for the
star. It's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a card like it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck, cause that's your birthday. You'll find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Look, mommy, I got the X, in the taking drugs.
They took my rings, they took my Rolex. I took out the brothers, said, damn, what's next? And they all around. Guns to my head, I think I'm going down. I can't believe this happened in my own town. And wings out with God, let me contemplate. I went to the cut and I see my homie Nate.
16 in the hole and one in the hole. Nate Dogg is about to make some money turn.
Now they dropping and yelling, it's a tad bit late.
Nate Dogg and Warren G had to regulate.
Got the freaks and that's a known fact. Before I got jacked, I was on the same track. Back up, back up, zone. N-A-T-E-M-E. The Warren to the G.
You are gutsy. I know who wrote this song, but you made it your version. Your dad is going to be so proud of you.